Yeah, let me start. Meanwhile, others will join. Okay. Yeah, in the last session, we are talking about different state management techniques. So we saw examples for client side and as well as server side techniques. Right. We saw example with a session. Right. We left with one state management technique like catcher. So it is similar like storing some information for some duration of time in a separate memory location like hardware mechanism only. That is similar. You can just refer this document for that implementation. I have clear examples on that. Okay. The same like sessions and applications. The only thing will vary is page output catcher, page fragment catcher. Just refer this document, you'll get a detailed information. So today's session is security implementation in ASP.NET. So if you observe any website, so whenever we observe a website like Gmail, so when we open Google, we were able to click on few items, right? So here I can view news, I can view calendar, I can go to Gmail. So when we are going to Gmail, if I, let me log out and show you. So I'm in a Google home page now. So when I click on a Gmail, it is taking me to login page, right? So the inbox and the view mail details pages are and my profile pages are restricted pages because they can be accessed only by a particular user who is authorized to access them. Okay. So whoever logs in into the system of Google, they only can access mailbox or viewing mails or profile settings or something like that. But they can access other pages here, right? They can click on news or they can go to YouTube. They can go to drive like that. There are few pages which are not restricted to access, right? But few pages are restricted to access and few are not. So when I'm clicking on Gmail, it is taking me to a login page first. Once I log in, it will take me to the a different page, like a inbox page, right? So whenever we develop any website, we will come across two things. First, restricted pages, non-restricted pages. So restricted pages are only accessible by the users who are authorized to do. Okay. Whoever given permission to access them, they can only access restricted pages. Okay. Non-restricted pages can be accessed by any public. Okay. Like reset password page, login page, new user registration page, about us page, contact us page, like this. So these pages are non-restricted pages. When it comes to profile edit, okay, profile details, some mailbox or some dashboard kind of pages, these are restricted pages. Those can be accessed only by the logged in users, right? So to implement such features, we use two concepts. So in order to get into the security implementation in ASP.NET, we must be familiar with the two terms. First is authentication. Next is authorization. Okay. So authentication, authorization. So what is mean by authentication and what is mean by authorization? Any idea? Before, do you have any idea related to that? Anyone? Hello. Hello. Sir. Am I audible?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So any idea about authentication and authorization? Yes, sir. No, just save some.
Awesome.
Okay, that's it. So authentication, So it's a process of checking a user credentials, whether they are valid or not. So you are entering username and password. So verifying them again is the stored details is called a authentication. Okay. Authentication is a process of checking whether user credentials are valid or not. So if you go to a login page, any of the login page, so you will be entering username and password, right? But when you're clicking this, you will be entering actually email and password. So that process is called authentication, validating those details. If those are correct, then you will be redirected to different page. Okay, that process is called authentication. Okay, even though you authenticated, you may not be accessible, you may not be able to access few pages. Like only admins can access few pages, super admins can access few pages, like that. In such cases, we call that process as a authorization. Authorization is a process of checking whether an authenticated user has rights to access restricted pages or not. Like if you take a school website, school related system, so principal can access few modules, teacher can access few modules, whereas a transport department can access few modules, right? Everyone will not have same access, right? So there will be a restriction on each module. So such process, such restriction is called authorization. Okay, authentication is a way of verifying user credentials. Okay, authorization is a way of accessing particular resource by the allowed users or not. To check that, we use authorization. Okay, these are the two important terms. So this is also one of the important interview question, like what is the difference between authentication and authorization? Okay, authorization is the process of checking whether an authenticated user has right to access a page or module. Okay, so suppose a user entered username and password and clicked on login button. Now you validated the details. Now what will happen? So if user credentials are valid, it will redirect to some dashboard page or mailbox page kind of thing, right? If they are not valid, we will display an error message like invalid username and password. So what is happening in the background if the credentials are valid? So whenever the credentials are valid, okay, user will be given a ticket called authentication ticket. Okay, if user credentials are valid, he will be given a ticket called authentication ticket, and this ticket will be in the form of cookies. Okay, a system will create a cookie, authentication ticket cookie. Okay, that will be used to identify that this user is authorized, authenticated user. Okay, this can be, this will be in the form of cookie. So when without this cookie, IIS will not identify you that like a authenticated user. Okay, so we talked about few things, right? Like restricted pages, non-restricted pages. Okay, in general, when we access any website, a ticket will be given called anonymous authentication ticket. Any user can access web page, right? So such tickets will be called as anonymous access. Every user will be given a ticket known as anonymous authentication ticket. Means user does not require any user ID and password to access restricted resources. Okay. Next, to implement authentication, we have three types. ASP.NET supports three types of authentication modes. So one is Windows authentication. Next is forms authentication. Third one is passport authentication. Okay, Windows authentication, forms authentication, passport authentication. Windows authentication. So we will see one by one. First, Windows authentication. So it is a process where just a second. Okay, so when we log in into our system, we will have some user credentials, right, to log into our system. So if we use those credentials to access any website, we call that as a Windows authentication. Okay, so whatever the Windows credentials we have, if we use them to authenticate with any website, we call that mode as a Windows authentication mode. So basically, this we use for only intranet applications. So if you have an intranet application, organizational application, okay, in such cases we use Windows authentication. So Windows authentication will use your Windows credentials to validate whether you are authenticated or not, whether you have access or not. In such cases, we use Windows authentication using your Windows credentials, Windows network credentials. We call it as an Active Directory. We will have an Active Directory. From that Active Directory, we will validate the users. So this is only useful for Windows authentication is useful for only intranet applications. Okay. Next thing, forms authentication. Okay, forms. This is the most common widely used authentication mode. Okay. So this is most widely used because we show some login page, right? Like username and password kind of thing. So this is most widely used, where we display username and password fields. So we display username and password fields where user will enter the credentials. Okay, so those credentials will be validated against our database stored data. If user credentials are valid, we will generate an authentication ticket. That big ticket will be traversed from client to server and page to page, so that it will identify the registered logged in user. Okay, so this is the most commonly and widely used authentication mode. Right. Next, passport authentication. This was implemented by Microsoft. So this mode is like, if you have group of websites, okay, if you have group of websites, if you want to implement only single authentication mode for all the group of websites, we can go for passport authentication. This was implemented by Microsoft for its group of websites. If we have to implement this, we have to perform some steps with the help of Microsoft, so that you can validate your users for those group of websites. Okay. So by default, suppose if you have a website and you want to implement this authentication mode, either of these three, you can only, out of these three, only one mode can be activated for any website. You cannot implement a combination of websites, combination of authentication modes. Okay. Any one authentication mode can be implemented for a single website. So the default is Windows. Okay. Default authentication mode is Windows. Like a customization, we do with the forms authentication. So to set this in a configuration file, we will set this implementation authentication mode in web.config file using authentication tag. Okay. So like this, authentication mode equal to Windows. If it is Windows mode, then we will specify Windows or forms or passport like this. Authentication mode equal to, okay. To set the authorization, we use authorization tag. Okay. To set authentication, we use authentication tag. To set the authorization, we use authorization tag. We'll have two properties called like two parameters, like allow and deny. Okay. Under authorization, we have two properties like allow and deny. So to which user, if we want to allow users, we can specify the users like this, allow users ABC. So users with the name ABC are allowed to access restricted pages, okay, secured pages. All other users are not allowed. If we specify star, all the users are allowed to visit the pages in the secured folder. Okay. So and deny users ABC like this. If you want to deny ABC, we can specify them under deny users equal to ABC. Right. If you specify star, all will be not allowed to access the pages in the secured folder. So if we specify question mark, deny users question mark. So in this case, only authorized users are allowed. Okay, unknown users, question mark means unknown. Unknown or unauthorized users are not allowed to visit pages present in the secured folder. Okay, so this is about authentication and authorization. So authentication is a process of validating the user credentials to check whether user is allowed to access page or not. Okay, authorization is a process of checking authenticated user has access or not. Like an admin can access only admin module, normal user can access only normal functionality. Like that, checking such access level is called authorization. Authentication is a process of verifying the user credentials and validating them again is the database. Okay, so this is about authentication and authorization. In authorization, in authentication we have three modes like Windows, Forms, Passport. So to set this, we have authentication authorization tags in web.config file. So like allow users, if we can specify the user names, like if you want to allow all the users, we can specify star. If we want to allow only authorized users, we can specify question mark. Okay. We discuss like what is Windows authentication based on the Windows user accounts. Okay, Windows authentication mode is like it is based on the user accounts. We validate the user against Windows credentials, that we called as a Windows authentication. So this will be this is the default mode. So we have an object called user.identity.name to get the logged in user details of the Windows authentication mode. Okay, this is widely used with the intranet applications, right? So the application can be designed in such a way that it can display all the active users, Active Directory users. This can be configured by the administrators, right? So this is about Windows authentication mode. This is the flow. First, client will send a request for the so client will send a request for the restricted page or secured page. So IIS will navigate you to the login page. Okay, by default IIS will navigate to login page. At login page, you will be entering your Windows system credentials. That will be validated, and if they are valid, it will generate a Windows authentication token, Windows authenticated token. Okay, to enable this, we have few steps here. Just refer this, right? So once you get the Windows authentication ticket, so the request will be handover to IIS. IIS will serve the response to the client. So first we will make a request to IIS for a restricted page. So IIS will navigate you to login page. Then login page credentials will be validated. If they are valid, it will generate a Windows authentication token. So that token will be given to IIS. IIS will process the response, process the request, and sends the response back to client. Okay. So this is the flow in Windows authentication mode, and these are the steps to enable it, right? Next one. So to implement forms or to implement forms or passport authentication mode, so we can configure our ASP.NET application. Okay. So in order to make that, we have to use authenticate mode. Okay. So this way, if you want to implement Windows, we can mention Windows. If you want to implement forms, we can implement forms mode in the web.config file. Suppose if I want to implement forms, I have to specify authentication mode equal to forms. If you don't specify anything, it will treat Windows authentication mode. So under system.web, we can mention that. These are the available options. The most widely used one is forms. Okay. The new option is federated also. Just refer about it. Forms. Passport, forms, Windows, none. Okay. Next thing. So forms authentication. So let's check what is the flow. So forms authentication, it uses a cookies to track users through their visit. First, user sends a request to the login like a restricted page or a secured page. So IIS will check whether user is logged in or not. If the user is not logged in, it will automatically redirect us to login page. So in the login page, we will enter username and password, and those will be validated against DB. Once those are validated, forms authentication ticket will be created. Okay, forms authentication ticket in the form of cookie will be created, and that will be given to IIS. IIS will process the request and sends the response. Okay. So all the websites, all kind of websites in the internet can be can use this authentication mode. Okay. Next, passport authentication. Like we have different applications under Microsoft. Like one is www.microsoft.com, hotmail.com, msn.com, windowslive.com, asp.net.com. Like this, there are different websites under a Microsoft group. So all these group of websites want to use some common authentication mode that we call passport authentication. Okay, here users will use some encrypted mechanism, encrypted cookie, to access the details of group of websites. Okay, in the group of website, they can use any one website details, any one website. Like I have Hotmail, so I can use Hotmail credentials to access any other details like Windows Live, MS, and Devhood, like that. So I can use Hotmail credentials. Okay. And that credentials I use for group of websites. So that process is called passport authentication. So client sends a request to IIS. IIS will transfer request to passport.com. So where you will enter any one website credentials, if they are valid, so it will create a passport authentication ticket. Right? That ticket will be given to IIS. IIS will serve the request to the client. So here we call an authentication ticket as a passport authentication ticket. This will be in the form of encrypted format of the encrypted information. Okay. So this is about different authentication modes. Sorry. Is it clear or any doubts?
Clear.
implement this, so we need to have few pages like this. So those are common for everyone, like default, news, new user, login, and inside this we need to have a web.config. Okay, so this is a common folder, and you need to have a secure folder inside that, like mails, inbox, compose, edit user, change password, like this, and it will have a web.config separate. Okay, and just design a web page, right? Design a web page and place all these buttons like this. I'll show you one page. I think I have here. Just a second. Just a second. Yeah, something like this. Suppose take one page, default.asp.x, put some links, news, mails, edit user. Okay, news, mails, edit user. So when I click news, it is an open page, so I should get news.asp.x. When I click edit user, it's a restricted page or secured page, so I should only get if I am a valid user. Okay. So it has to go to login page. If the credentials are valid, then it has to go to edit user page. If I click mails also, as it's a secured page, it has to go to login page. Or if I already logged in, directly can go to mails.aspx page. So we have to create 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pages. Okay, like this. One is default, next login. So 5 pages. Okay. This is the flow to implement forms authentication, right? So whenever we click on a restricted page, it has to go to login page, or it has to check whether we are already logged in or not. If we are logged in only, it has to display the pages. Otherwise, it has to ask us the username and password, right? To set this, what we have to do? We have to set web.config file in that folder, and in that folder also we have to set the forms authentication mode, like here. So these are the global files, so we will have web.config here by default. Under secured folder, we have to have a web.config. In that web.config, we have to set allow users question mark, so that only authorized users will be allowed, right? So if we set that, we will not be able to access these pages, right? And for the each button, just redirect them like this, and set the in the root folder. Just write this code: authentication mode equal to forms. So we have to restrict the authorization, right? So for that, we have to set this. So to implement authorization and restrictions, go to web.config file of this secured folder, then write authorization deny users question mark. So unknown users will not be allowed to access secured folder. If we run and check this application, we will get 3 buttons when we click that. So it will take you to the login page like this. We'll see that once. So let me check I have a login page or not. I think I have created empty. First, I'll add a page. Web form, yes. I'm just taking it as home. Okay, home page. Now in this page, I'll place 3 buttons. button, button, button. So I took 3 buttons. So first one is news. Sorry. Next one is mailbox or inbox. Some restricted page. And third one is profile page. Okay. Let me add a folder. Add new folder. Let me name it as secured. Okay. So let me add a configuration file. Where is that? New item. Configuration file. Dot. Yeah, here. Web configuration file. Okay. This will be available in the this will be available under secure folder. So to support that, so I have to set authorization. Okay, what is the syntax? Authorization deny users question mark. So that this will not be accessed by the other users. Unauthorized users. So if they are authorized only, they can access this. Now under this secured folder, I'll add required files. So first one is inbox. Next one is my profile or some profile page. Okay. I'm not adding any code. I'll just simply put a message. My profile page. Okay. I'll go to inbox page. This is my inbox page. Right, so I have a home page. Right, I have a home page. In home page, I have news button, inbox button, profile button. So let me add one more page for news. So news.aspx here, and this is my sample web page. Right, so let me run and check once. So I need to have a login page also, right? So we'll see what will be the error if you don't have login page, or what will happen when we click on profile like that. Okay. So first I'm opening home page. Okay. Oh, sorry, I forgot to write the click events. So click on that. We want to navigate, right? So first clicking on button one, we have to navigate to response.redirect to news page. News.aspx page.
Sir, news page we write in secured folder or outside the secured folder?
Outside the folder, because it is accessible to all the users. Okay. So whatever we want to keep like open access or non-restricted pages can be outside the folder. Okay. So even we can add folder and we can keep in that there is no issue. But if you write like this, like if you add a web.config and if you place this thing, then it will restrict. Until that, it won't restrict you. Even you can have a folder and you can add the pages. Okay.
Okay.
Just a second. I'll put properly. Authorization deny. Just a second. Deny space users. Okay. This is the syntax. Authorization denied users equal to question mark. Okay. The second page response dot redirect. So I have to redirect to secured folder. So secure / what is the second button? Inbox. Okay. Inbox dot ASPX. The third one is response dot redirect. It's under security folder. I want to go to profile page. Okay. Let me run and check. Now clicking on news page. So I'm going to news page, sample news page. So when I'm clicking on inbox, let's see what is going to happen. See here, it is going to secured inbox, but an error is displaying like access is denied because I said, what did I do here? Deny users question mark. So only unknown users are denied. Only authorized users are allowed. So as I am an unknown user as of now, so access is denied. So if I have a login page, it will take me to the login page. Let's see that. You can see here unauthorized login failed due to server configuration. You can see that here. Okay. If you have a login page, it will automatically take me to the login page. Let's see that now. Just a second. So I'll add a login page outside the folder. Login.xpx. Let me take username and password here. First label, then text to pass. Then label, then text box, and then button. Okay. So first, username, this is password page, so password label, this is just a design as per your convenience. I'm just to save the time, I'm not designing anything. Clicking on login, putting in login text. Just to design with a table, take a table and a design properly. So now let me run and check once what will happen now. So I'll go to actually home page first. So I'm in home page, clicking on news. So it is taking me to news page. So clicking on inbox. Okay, authorized login field due to server configuration. Okay, let me set that also. So we have to actually set the login URL. Okay, so that we can set We can set that in the authentication or authorization. Just a second, I forgot that. Somewhere I could add, yeah, forms. So in the global page, oh sorry, I forgot to set this. That's why this. So in the global page, we have to set authentication mode. So it is by default Windows, so it is not clean. So let me set it to forms. So let me set it and run once. Yeah, see now. So I set authentication mode to forms authentication in web.config in first web main web.config authentication mode equal to forms. So when I set that, so when clicking on inbox, right, it is taking me to login page. Okay, so it is taking me to login page. Why? So we talked about that already. So whenever somewhere here. Yeah. So whenever we request for a secured resource, IIS will redirect you to login page. So once the credentials are valid, then it will create a forms authentication token, right? Then the request will be served. So by default, it will navigate you to login page. Suppose. So how it will know that my login page is login.aspx? By default, it will check for the login.aspx page. Okay. Suppose in your application, you might not have login page. You might have renamed it in a different manner. Okay. Sign in page. Okay. User page, user credentials page, like that. You may write like that. So in such cases, we have to set the login URL. Okay. We have to set login URL. To set that, yeah, forms. Okay. I think it is not here. Let me check. Suppose if you have a different name other than login.aspx, okay, we can set this tag like this, forms login URL equal to your page name. Like if I have sign in, signin.hpx, you can set that so that it will automatically take you to the that page. Okay, let me run and check. Yeah, we should not set these forms here. So where it will go to an authentication forms. So let me write outside inside system.web. Here also to be not showing. Authentication authorization. Let me check. Used it long back. So system.web more forms over inside authentication. Sorry. Now it will look for signin.hpx when we are clicking on a mailbox button. Okay, let's check that. So what is our page name? Home page. So now I'm clicking on inbox. See here, server error in application. The resource cannot be found. Which resource? Signin.hpx, because I set a login URL as signin.hpx. So that's why it is unable to find that. And if you observe one more thing, so see here, when I'm clicking on inbox button, so if you observe the URL, it is actually trying to take me to signin.hpx. And after this, if you observe this path, return URL, question mark, return URL. So it become a query string, and its name is return URL. And it is having the actual path where we want to redirect, like secured inbox. So I want to navigate to inbox page actually, but as I am an unknown user, so it is taking me to login page first. Then once we log in, it will automatically takes me to this page, secured inbox.aspx page. If you click on profile also, you will see that return URL, secured profile.aspx. So what is the return URL here? It's a query string. Once we authenticate, it will automatically redirect us to this return URL page. So let's do that. Let's check that how it will take us. So for now, I'm just removing this tag. Okay, so we have login.aspx page. On clicking this login button, we want to navigate the user. Okay, so we want to navigate with the user. So let me write the code for login. So you guys have any session now?
No, sir.
No session, right?
Okay. Yes.
So first, how do we verify user credentials against DB? We will write that code. Then we will navigate user to a different page, secured pages. Okay. So let me take query first, string query equal to, so select count of star. So we want to check with the given credentials how many users are available. Okay. Select count of star from users, where So user ID, he will send us through the text box, right? So for that, I'm just appending the text box one. So text box one dot text is the username, right? Then next thing. So next thing is password, where user ID and password equal to, then I will append text box two value to the query. Okay. After this, I have to close single quotes. Yeah. So what I'll do is like when I enter username and password, I want to validate these details. So on clicking login button, I have to validate whether these credentials are existing in database or not, whether these are valid or not. So for that, I have to write a query. So to write such query, so we use like this: select count of star from users. Which table? We should have some users table. From users, where user ID equal to text box one dot text and password equal to text box two dot text. As of now, we don't have any users table. We will create this later. For now, let me write the code, okay, so that you will get an idea. So what we actually do. So I want to execute the command. So to get that, let me import system dot SQL server system.data.sql client. Okay. So if I import that, I'll get SQL command. SQL command cmd equal to new SQL command object. So I have to pass connection as well as the command here. Right. So connection. So before that query, I'll pass here. So I need to have a connection. So let me copy that. So I have a connection string here. So I pass that connection string. I need to create an object. All right. String to SQL connection. Okay. Let me write it. First, SQL connection. SQL con. New SQL connection, and I have to pass that string here, const string. So I can give connection object here. Okay. Now I want to execute the command query. So this query I want to execute. So to execute action queries, we use execute. So here I'm going to get only single value. So I can use execute scalar actually, right? Suppose if you have any action queries, like if you are fetching some details or you are deleting or updating that, you can use execute non-query. So here, as I'm going to get only one value, so I can go for execute scalar. So cmd dot execute scalar. Okay, now this is going to be written object type, so I have to convert it into integer. Because I am going to get only count of usernames and passwords matching. Okay, so if I get count equal to one, what? If I get count one, what is the What does it mean? What does it mean? So because there is only one user with the user ID and password, so you are a valid user. If I get count zero, my credentials are wrong, right? So whatever the credentials I enter, those are wrong. So in such case, to display a message, let me add a label here. To display search message, I can add a label. So label validation or label result, LBL result. I just need, sorry, text, not text, should be ID. We can give any other name. So to access that, label result dot text equal to, we can set like invalid pass username and password. So if I get count zero, there are no matching results. If I get other than count zero, then it is a valid return. So valid user. So in such case, what we do? Forms authentication. We have one class like forms authentication. Dot redirect from login page. We have one method which will actually text box one dot text. So here I'm putting true for now. I'll tell you what is this. So this is under web.security namespace. So system.web.security namespace, we have forms authentication class. Okay. This class is having multiple methods. We'll see one by one. First, forms authentication dot redirect from login page. So when we use this method, redirects an authenticated user back to originally requested URL or the default URL. So when we use this method, redirect from login page, so it will take your username, whether we want to create a cookie or not, and that path we can specify. Actually, we will see what is this. So for now, just what it will do, it will redirect the user from authenticated user from login page to requested URL page, okay, requested page. So as of now, as I don't have any users table and any user details, let me do one thing. I'll keep this on top for now, just for testing. Let's see whether it will work or not. So I just commented this code. So what I'm doing, whatever the username I enter here, so I am passing that to redirect from login page method. And passing to create, telling it to create a persistent cookie. So that's why I'm passing true. So whenever I click a login button, it will take me to the requested page directly. Let's see, will it work or not? So first, let me go to home page first. So in home page, when I click news page, it is taking me to news page. When I click profile, it will take me to login page. So I'm entering MyPath. Password also I'm entering as MyPath. So now clicking on login page. See now here. So actually it came to login page. Once we validate, we have to go to secured profile page. So let me check login. See here. Now it is taking me to my profile page, right? So when I click inbox, so as I'm already logged in, so it is taking me to inbox page. Okay, because we wrote like forms authentication dot redirect from login page and use this as username. So whatever the text you entered, it will take it as a username and creating a cookie. So that cookie is a persistent cookie. Okay, it will have a 20 minutes session time. So till 20 minutes, and if this application is running, you will be able to, you are a valid user. You are a valid user. So previously when we click on profile page, it used to take you to login page. Now you are able to go to any restricted page because you are a logged in user now. So the logic is to validate the logged in user. So what is the logic? First, we will validate user credentials with the database. Okay, the query is select count of star from users where user ID equal to whatever the text we entered and the password equal to whatever the text we entered. We will get the count. If count is zero, you are unauthorized. If count is one or more than one, so you are in general, we will have only one user. So we should have such validation. So when count is one, so we are using this forms authentication class to redirect to the page which we requested. So how it will know which page we want to redirect? Like I might have clicked profile or I might have clicked inbox, but how it will know? Based on the written URL that is in the query string. So written URL, it will navigate you to written URL page. So it is taking some username here and creating a cookie. Okay, you see the definition here: string username, create persistent cookie. We are sending true, so it will create a cookie so that until that cookie is available, you can access the restricted pages. Yes, any doubt? Hari, I think you have raised hand. Is it by
me? Yes, sir.
Secondly, or do you have any doubt?
No, sir. I by mistake. Okay.
So this is about security implementation, and we have few more methods. We will see an example for them tomorrow. Like we have different methods here. Forms authentication dot sign out method we have, set up cookie we have, right? Authenticated method we have, like that. We will have different methods like get redirect URL, get auth cookie. We have few methods, we will see them. Redirect from login page, redirect to login page, set auth cookie, sign out. Yeah, we will see these tomorrow, and if possible, we will see deployment also tomorrow. Okay, in 2 or 3 sessions, we will complete all the ASP.NET related topics that we are going to cover. Any doubts till now? So what we did?
So database, sir. Database lo AI IDs unne, only wale access chestara mana inbox page ni.
Avunu, ikkada ade rasam kada. Users table lo. Users table లో ఉన్న యూజర్ ఐడి అండ్ ఆ పాస్వర్డ్ మ్యాచ్ అయితేనే మ్యాచ్ అయిన యూజర్ కి అలౌ చేస్తాం ఇక్కడ. రేపు యూజర్స్ టేబుల్ క్రియేట్ చేసి చెక్ చేద్దాం ఒకసారి
కొన్ని ఐడిస్ పాస్వర్డ్
ఇన్సర్ట్ చేసి ఓన్లీ ఆ యూజర్స్ ని అలౌ చేసేలాగా వి విల్ వాలిడేట్ దట్ టుమారో.
ఓకే,
సో వాట్ వి డిడ్ ఫస్ట్, so in our website I just added few files like home page and news page and login page, right? These three are accessible by anyone because those are not restricted. So what I did, I added a secure folder. Inside that secure folder I added inbox and profile pages. These are secured and should be accessed by only logged in user. So I set that in web.config like authorization deny users equal to ? So unknown users are not allowed to access this folder. Access this folder where web.config is present. So secured folder will not be accessed by anyone until you have a valid cookie, forms authentication cookie. Okay. So this is what we did, and we defined login URL in the main page. In the main web.config, we set authentication mode equal to forms, and if you have a login page with the name login, then no issue. Otherwise, we have to set forms login URL equal to that page name. Okay, so that it will take you to that page default if you are not logged in. So this is what we covered today. So we will see few methods with Forms Authentication class tomorrow, and we'll add some user credentials in the database and we'll validate that. Right? Any questions?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. We will see the remaining topic tomorrow.